is Carolyn. And then Robbie Thomas.
So I walked into the board.
He's such a cool guy. He puts it in.
I've been so long. But, you know, I was gonna put stuff on the whiteboard, and I was gonna put brown around the windows, like simulate.
Yep, he's a cook, and also Maya is studying for Sean Wright as well.
So like, sorry, And then I had to quickly type the paper, walk my video, and print it off and give it to you.
Then I'm thinking about either double majoring or minor.
What am I gonna?
Hey, Lena, think about picking up a minor. Are you about picking up a line on a minor?
Oh, but when I want to pick a minor, it's a problem.
It is a problem, you.
It's just one more thing.
Lena, you're the problem.
I am the problem.
I'm keeping fingers crossed for that. That will come tomorrow. All right, it'll make us cross.
Are you ready to come in?
Yes, I told Todd I'd come in late tomorrow night.
What?
Nothing.
All right, you guys, today, we're going to talk about faith and what it means and who influences our faith, who inspires our faith, what inspires our faith. This is going to be the dialogue. This opening slide are three of my favorite people in the world as far as they inspire me. All the quotes are fantastic, but mainly I want to see the variety here, right? These are people that influence my faith every day. So when we come to worship today, I want you thinking about what and who helped you in your faith journeys, in your faith lives. So as we go to the next slide, we're going to look at the announcements. We got a bunch of announcements coming in. So we've got Chaplain Chat, Tuesday, September 19th, 11 to 12:30 at the library. We're right there by, Einstein's, right? Einstein's, we're over there. Oh, we got a table reserved. Dinner and devotional this Sunday. Lena, are you on still?
Yeah.
Okay, so 6 p.m. to the end, 7:30. I mean, depends on when you got it.
I'm on.
So, okay, good. So, we'll see if we can have pizza again. and we'll work that. Worship every Thursday, 7 p.m. I was hoping we'd get a better crowd tonight, but thank you all for being here. It's fantastic. This October, 12th through the 14th, is your fall break. We're going to be doing a work trip to Kemmerer Village, which is a Presbyterian house for adolescents and young men and women. We're going to go and help with landscape and equine. They have horse therapy there, and so you're going to get to meet the therapist there. And I don't know if she'll have you guys help with the horses or what, but we went last summer from faith ride and had a great time. So, and then the 29th, we're going to go up to the Quad Cities, to the mosque, to the Islamic Center in the Quad Cities. And the Imam Bashar is going to meet with us and have a Q&A with us. So if you have questions about the Islamic faith and understanding, and he's going to help us understand that and grow a little bit, right? So that's the 29th. If you want to do that, come see me or email me or let me know.
I don't know what happened.
Okay. I have faith that we'll figure this out. So, all right. So, this quote is what I want you thinking about as we go into this time of worship. This is by Brian McLaren in his book, We Make the World by Walking. He said, faith was never intended to be a destination, a status, or a holding tank, or a warehouse. Instead, it was to be a road, a path, a way out of the old and destructive patterns and into new and creative ones. So faith is not a stagnant thing. It's a constant growth, and it's constantly moving and enjoying and engaging. And so our challenge is to really grow into that and understand that our faith is constantly evolving. So now Michael's going to lead us in a call to worship.
Good evening.
Please join me in the call to worship. We gather this evening hoping to explore and to engage in a fruitful experience.
An experience that acknowledges the importance of your love and grace, most comforting God.
Let us all accept the call to open our hearts and to trust in God to experience greater faith and calling.
It is in this time of worship that we are asked to accept the challenge to live life that could create a better world, a world that God is calling us to create.
Let us be granted the strength to embody a life of faith that lifts us out of our fears.
The Canaanite woman shows us the faith that we are asked to live up to.
Let us be open to learning that faith that she richly teaches us.
Thank you, Michael. All right, so we're going to break up a little bit, and you guys can two and two and three. Michael, you can hang with them. And I want you just to talk about this. Think about who are your influences in your faith life? Who influences your faith? And why? Why do they help you, or why does that characteristic matter in your faith life? And then what are those important attributes for living faithfully in your lives? So let's go ahead and just have a conversation about that, discuss these questions amongst each other, and then we'll come back and we'll talk a little bit about it. So. And you guys can be one group.
We can just be two right here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. We can change it up.
There you go.
Just so I'm not with the same two people.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to go to the next one.
as I could with John, but it's been to the point that I'm comfortable with my faith with her, even though, yes, her faith is probably much more different than mine, because I've never truly talked about her shop anybody. She's strange to my faith with her, because
2 hours.
See, I haven't had the greatest time to think about that, but the thing is, because I knew her first at church, because we're in the same choir together, and then we started dating. But then just during that time, I got to know her as a person, just unlike a lot of other people I've met in my life personally. Somebody who has just a faith of her own, especially within her family, and a very deep, close connected friends as well. And that's something I wanted to share with her as well.
Yes.
All right, let's come back a little bit. It looks like you guys had some good conversation going on, right? So tell me a little bit about who and why, or who and what are your influences? Anybody want to share what they talked about?
Well, one of the people I talked about, and it's two very specific people, and one of them is actually you. I appreciate that. And one of the most important attributes as well that you have been influencing me with my faith as well is just being able to discover my own faith and grow with that as well as a person, what I truly believe in, and being able to share that with you and everybody else in my life as well.
It's fantastic. Each of you has a unique faith, right? And Ryan, you said that very well, and I'm extremely humbled and honored, so thank you so much. But anybody else want to share? All right, so this is a really intimate question, right? I mean, your faith life means something, it matters to you. But I think as you guys grow in your faith, it's important to kind of dissect it a little bit, because it helps you understand what are the things that lead you, in your life. What are the things that center you in your life, and help you have like that moral compass for many, or have that concept or that understanding of what the divine is. So thank you guys for sharing that. And so the next thing we do is the prayers for the people, and Ryan's gonna lead us in that. And when we're finished, when Ryan stops, we'll start the Lord's Prayer, and we'll do it with Dennis and Debra.
Most faithful God, help us to walk with one another and to embrace an understanding of living our faith lives daily. Today, help us to always walk with one another so that we may be willing to be in community constantly. Instruct us to empty our fears and anxieties to become fruitful and faithful in all we do. Let us be willing to take risks to show the world your deep compassion for creation. Teach us to care deeply for all of creation and to work to sustain and nurture that creation. Inspire us to be open to communing with our friends, neighbors, and enemies to show the world your profound love and grace. Instill us in a sense of wondering that continuously is your feet, is seeking to learn and grow in your precious image. Let our hands be your hands and our feet be your feet. Encourage us to embody your love in our actions and words. We ask that you direct us towards finding our true selves and help others to do the same. Today, we continue to ask that you may be with the Moroccan people as they recover from such a devastating earthquake, and the Libyan people as they try and rebound from the horrific flooding in their streets. For our campus, Lord, teach us to be the community that you are asking us to be. All of this, we lift in the precious words you have taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
So today's text comes from Matthew chapter 15, 21 through 28. This is one of my personal favorite texts to study and to look at. And it's entitled, the subtitle for it is The Faith of the Canaanite Woman. And so once again, I'm going to do it like I've been doing it as far as telling you the story of this text. And if you want to read along, this is the Message version, Eugene Peterson's Message version. So this story takes place that Jesus is traveling between Tyre and Sidon. And, you know, he's wiped out, but as he travels, this woman kept coming to him, and say, you know, have mercy on me, Jesus. My daughter's sick, and I know that you could heal her. Have mercy on me. And Jesus just kind of kept avoiding her. And finally, she made such a fuss that the disciples looked at him and said, you got to get rid of her. She's driving me nuts. Get her out of here. So Jesus looks at the woman and says, what is going on, essentially? And she says, Master, heal my daughter. And Jesus looks at her and says, essentially, I'm not here for you. I'm here for the Israelites. And he calls her a dog. He says, he's not throwing the crumbs off the table. And so this woman looks right back at him and says, even the dogs get the crumbs. And Jesus tells her, and I think this is one of the most empowering moments in the Gospels, because Jesus shows this amazing gift of openness to this Canaanite woman. He says, your faith is so strong that your daughter will be healed. And she left, and her daughter was healed. That's such a powerful, powerful imagery for us to look at. Because, first of all, we can argue the fact that Jesus calls her a dog, and that doesn't seem like Jesus at all. But what Jesus teaches us in this text is that he understands. And he learns and he grows from this moment. Jesus' faith is actually impounded or impacted and grows because he has the ability to meet with this woman. This woman teaches him a great lesson. And it's important for us to get, because that's what our faith lives are all about. Our faith lives are all about that concept of continuously growing. So I want to share with you some faith quotes. And we'll talk about it a little bit. So, first one comes from, I'm ahead of myself. So, our meditative music tonight is going to be Have a Little Faith in Me by John Hyatt. So, Kelsey's going to play that for us.
And you can no longer see.
Okay, so have a little faith in me. One of the attributes that I had up on that slide was trust, right? And I think that trust is actually the basis for the first quote we're going to look at. If we put it up here, the first quote we're going to look at is my favorite definition of faith. It's by Dr. Martin Luther King. And it says, faith is taking the first step even when you don't see the whole staircase. Faith is taking that first step even when you don't see the whole staircase. Have you guys ever had that moment where you had to take that step up those stairs without knowing where it will lead? Anybody ever experienced that? Anybody want to share that? Share their story a little bit? It's tough, I know. Well, I'll tell you what. I'll share it with you a little bit.
I was going to say that my experience going from high school to college, I didn't know where exactly I was going to end up, and the pandemic wasn't really any help. So I was kind of confused as to where I was going to go and like where I would end up.
That's a great story. Thank you, Kyle. That those.
My dream one was the first time I actually decided to be here and become an actor. Because I was been the star until I was a freshman in high school, and I always was like bad and like I suck at speeches here at school, like whether it be with a group or just by myself, I've never been good at it. And like just getting up, there's so much anxiety going up on stage, but I've always loved like art as like for moving through, so like feeling try, and that's something I fell in love with immediately when I started doing it. So it's one of those things where like I'm glad I got to do it because I get to have so many good experience. Here's actually the main reason I even knew of this college, because I had an audition. And so kind of just cool to see how that, like you said, to see the whole staircase. At first I would never have thought I'd be having a theater major when I started. Been doing theater for 4 years of my life.
That's wonderful. See, this is great. These are the stories, right? And everybody has them, you know. Anybody else want to share their story? Or a story, Michael?
I guess I was in the similar boat as Nyla. I didn't think I was going to go to a 4-year major league. Finances were a big thing for my family, so it was just really community college that I thought was going to be my only place, and I felt like I was going to get the college experience. But I found as if that I took that chance of applying to as much colleges as I could, and one of those colleges happened to be this college. I thought it was just like Mammoth College. I didn't know what the college was. Like I was like, oh, I got to email from, but I took that chance, and I happened to find that light at the end of the tunnel of just being so grateful of getting the experience of college experience and being able to be provided a lot in terms of finance. finances, like applying to that whole scholarship competition and like winning one of those scholarships, like helped change a lot.
The Brian? So among the lines of definitely going to college, I'm technically a transfer from a community college, but I took a gap semester in between because I had already graduated. I had gotten my associate's degree, and now I didn't know what I wanted to do, honestly. I wanted to do theater, but I don't know, I didn't have a goal. I didn't know where that staircase was taking me, if there was even one to begin with. And then somebody just asked me, "You should try to go to Wallace College. You might find something great there." And I have since then. And now I found that staircase, honestly, and I found even more with that.
That's fantastic. And anybody else?
I have nothing related to college. I think for me, faith was just taking the first step and just getting out there, not even just in like academics, but just like, I'm a very young lady, but I'm very like socially shy. So it's like starting to find jobs and finding like people to hang out with. It was a lot, but it made me, because coming into college, I didn't know anyone from here. So it was kind of like scary. And then I really started putting myself out there, and I took the first step and joined the sorority. And then next thing you know, that sorority led me to many other opportunities. So, yeah.
So these are wonderful. Kelsey?
Mine was actually going into senior year of high school. COVID happened my junior year, and school shut down, and I went full time into my job. And I remember getting offered a management position at my job I was working at the time. And then all of a sudden they were like, "Oh yeah, school's going back in session." And I had to make the decision, do I want to just continue on? Because I was like getting my life together. I was looking to find a place. Do I want to continue on with my education and stop what I'm doing to potentially fail? Or do I want to continue on with little fights? It didn't really leave for much build for me. So I had to take the step in the right direction, although I knew what that was.
Thank you. These are all wonderful, you guys. Thank you so much for sharing. Okay, so I'll share with you a little bit of my story, right? That because I've had a bunch of these moments before. Of course, I'm twice your age, so just letting you know that they're going to continue to happen, guys, right? But when I was here at Monmouth College, I stepped onto the campus after being in the Navy and having two babies, and or a baby and a half, one was on the way, and about 4 weeks into my first semester here, I walked out. I was going to drop out. I was going to quit, right? And it was a professor, Carolyn Suda, that grabbed hold of me and said, "You're not quitting, and we're going to be there." And she was my staircase for a long time. That's why these questions I ask you are really important, because these are the people that led me to the faith of having a trust in God to get me through, right? For me, I was not in that place when that happened. But thankfully they did, right? So the next quote we got is do your little bit of good where you are. It's those little bits of good that overwhelm the world. Desmond Tutu. So now, you want to talk about faith? You have to have faith to do your little bit of good, don't you? Right? I mean, because sometimes it doesn't feel like you're going to do good. Sometimes it feels like you're not doing enough. Am I right? You guys ever get that way? You ever feel that way? Like you're just not getting enough done? But we gotta have faith that every bit of little work that we're doing, every bit of those little deeds goes into connecting the dots for somebody. Goes into helping somebody. Remember our first week we talked about what are some of those things we can do to build community, right? These are the things. Ryan talked about just saying hi to somebody, I think it was you, Ryan, and then Fatima said that, you know, you can just sit with somebody, right, at lunch, and, you know, I mean, Michael, acknowledging people, right? Those are the things that we have to, you know, those are those little things, but those take faith. You gotta have faith and trust, especially now in the world today, right? How often do you walk through campus and somebody doesn't say hi to you? You just walk by without looking at you? Happen a lot? So it takes faith to jump out there and say, "Hey, how are you doing?" Right? I always joke that people think I'm weird, I think, because I try to say hi to everybody that I walk by, right? Because I think it's important that we do this, though. but we gotta have faith that we can do this and connect with people. Because if we don't, we're gonna continue to polarize and we're gonna continue to divide, right? So faith is a huge piece of the puzzle. The next one is, this is Thomas Burton. You guys haven't heard from him yet. You'll hear from him a lot also, because he's my guy. Once again, I'll let you know, Carolyn Suda introduced me to him. But he's a Trappist monk from Kentucky, and he is amazing. He passed away in 68, but he's an amazing spiritual leader. But he says the man of faith who has never experienced doubt is not a man of faith. Anybody here have doubts about God? Anybody ever have a doubt about God? Anybody? It's okay. It's all right.
I'm no caller.
It was God. God's calling us. Oh. So that's the thing though. Too often we're told don't doubt things, right? Don't have questions. But the reality is, if you know all the answers, do you have faith at all? No. Right? What do you need faith for if you know everything? I always joke, and Fatima's probably heard me say this multiple times, but I've been studying this for 20 plus years, right? You know what I know? What I don't know. Because that's faith. Understanding that God is much bigger than we ever could imagine. And Merton's just reminding us, it's not about having all the answers. It's about understanding. It's okay to ask questions and seek to grow in your faith. So the next question Merton brings us to is, I really fell in love with his faith quotes, guys, so you got one more after this. So reason is in fact the path to faith. And faith takes over when reason can say no more. It's a similar quote as last, right? Faith takes over when you can't explain it, right? Folks, there's no reason for me to be sitting here as your chaplain in the grand scheme of things, right? There's no reason where that makes sense. It's just a God thing. I came here 20 years ago to become a sports broadcaster. I was heading to Green Bay, right? Well, I'm a broadcaster, but a very different kind, right? And I couldn't be happier. God knew more than I did. Reasonably, in my head, I knew what was right, but God sent me on a different direction. You understand what I'm saying? So when you've got those questions and you've got that discernment path, it's okay to get past the reason section, because you'll often find God in that gray. How many of you guys have lived a life where you thought it's all black or white? It's this or it's that. Then you got to college and what happened? Did you learn there's a whole lot of gray? That's good. Because in God's life, there's a whole lot of gray. In God's creation, there's a whole lot of gray. There's a whole lot of challenging stuff ahead. And so the next final quote from him, a faith that is afraid of other people is not faith at all. This is huge, because how often have you heard people say God loves this person but doesn't love this person? That's not faith. Faith is understanding that God cares for all of creation, that God cares for you as you are, because you are a child of God. You are worthy, and that's so important for us to recognize. Faith is bigger than any fear that you can imagine. Faith pushes us past fear-driven theology. And what I mean by that is that theology says if you don't do this, you're going to hell. Or if you don't act like this, you're going to hell. Or if you act like this, you're going to hell, right? Faith takes us way past that into a true realm of faith, peace, and service. It's fantastic when you get there. Because no longer are you afraid of God, you revere God. Because you understand how big God is and how amazingly, lovingly, God reaches out to each of you to lift you up. That's awesome. But you can't get there when you're living in fear. And then finally, Father Greg Boyle says, God can get tiny if you're not careful. If we don't live faithful lives, God gets real tiny. And what he means by that is God gets tiny when we think God dislikes or hates anybody that we hate. That's a tiny God. Our God is much bigger than that. Our God is so much more than we can fathom. But it's awesome. And you guys are the future, right? you know, the question that we got was, what are my influences in faith? What influences me daily in my faith? And so I thought about this, trying to answer it, and I was like, oh yeah, King, Tutu, Merton, all the guys you saw today. But you know who else does that, does this for me, gives me faith every day? It's each of you. It's all of you. Because you are amazing individuals. You show creativity and awe and wonder to me every day. When I'm kind of down or whatever, I get giggling with somebody. We have a conversation. We enjoy each other's company, right? That's your gifts. Don't let anybody tell you differently. You're all wonderful creations from God. And so as we go forth from this place, remember that, and that your faith is constantly and charged to evolve and grow, so you can never get to a place where you think you know God so well that there's nothing more to learn, because God's bigger than anything you can ever imagine. Next. Lena?
Gracious God, as we close this time of worship, let us be open and willing to go forth and live faithful lives as servants to your creation. Let us seek to represent your good news in everything we do. Teach us to listen to you and to look for you in all of creation. Let us now go in peace.
Amen. Thank you, everybody. Remember, Tuesday, chaplain chat. Next Thursday, worship again in here, 7 p.m. If you got a question, go ahead and put that in the small basket over here when you leave. The questions, as we talked about last week, the questions are everything you ask. I go through them. I'll pick one to put on Instagram and in a, what do they call it, a story.
It's Instagram Reel. Which will be posted on like our actual feed. So if you guys aren't following our Instagram, please go follow it.
Yeah. Fatima is great at teaching me social media. I mean, that it's fantastic. So what we'll do is I answer one question, and like today's service was actually written around one of our questions. So I'm also doing that with them. So if you've got a question, it's burning. Write it down. You don't have to write your name. Write it anonymously. Put it in the basket, and I'll check those out and try to answer them all by the end of the semester. So thank you guys for joining me. I enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed it. Have a wonderful weekend, and walk faithfully in the glory of God. Go in peace. Amen.
If you guys also can't come up with any questions right now, you guys can DM the Instagram.
There you go.
See that.
She's going to keep me at my step toes.
All right. I got to run back.